Okay, let's try that. Get the... Okay, here we go. We're gonna get it in gear, I guess, first. We're gonna go 400, we're gonna go 800. 800 RPMs. Make sure everything is cleared here. Bit of a rough ride, I think. There we go. Now let's see if we can't clean that up. Slightly off center. Come up just a hair. I'm gonna do 5,000s, I think. Slow feed. debating turning the camera off and bringing it back. I think I'll just keep it running. Down a little bit because my work is slowing down. Okay, I got a bit of a sharp nub there, which means I'm a hair low. Okay, somebody contacted me that has a machine just like this. They got a short video of this thing running pretty high speed with the top off, showing all the lubrication in the headstock. Unfortunately, they know about as much about it as I do. They probably know more than me, but won't admit it. But I'm reaching out to them for help on my cross travel and carriage travel. Well, he has neither cross nor carriage. And I told him what I knew about the carriage travel, and I think he can fix that. Brian was telling me, I was talking about taking the apron off, and Brian was giving me some ideas. I don't exactly remember all the details, but I would have been wrong in my approach of removing the apron. Apparently, I can take everything off at the gearbox side. And I guess that's an easier approach. But I have to reread that email for that comment and see exactly what it means. I'm getting more excited to get the crossfeed working after seeing one of my old videos where I was running them both at the same time, carriage and cross. So we get a blank slate here to try to emulate something like this. And I think this time we'll probably go to 50,000th depth. And I'm going to attempt this pattern starting with the circle and then having it ever expanding. Try to get them all the same size this time. Now there's a lot of interrupted cut there, and I'm not sure if I'm going to have the swing to be able to do that. But I will do the best we can. Okay, let's give this a try. The phase converter on. Let me get my depth gauge set up. I'm going to go 25 thousandths deep. I'm going to zero that. Right there. And probably a little too fast. And probably wasting your time here. What I want is a tiny circle. That's like that. The thickness of these shavings are like, well, tinfoil is actually too thick to describe it. Well, it's not really what I was expecting. Let me take it in an inch. So, quarter to half. I'm going to just pass 3/4. And there's an inch. Back up to the plate, set my zero. Okay, let me do another. Let's do another inch. This isn't what I want. 1, 2. Four times around with the dial. Okay, I'm gonna bring it back. And I'm gonna do a little rotation of the chuck. Okay, we're going to, I'm going to treat the outside of this a little bit. Okay, I might have something here that I can live with. I'm going to bring you back. Find the button to turn you off. Okay. Hopefully that'll work. Okay, let's see what happens here. So let me get up here and get kind of zeroed out. I don't want to take too much away. Okay. So I believe these are 15 thousandths. So I'm going to just do 5 thousandths. Okay, 7,000ths. I'm gonna lock the carriage. Okay, hopefully that gives you kind of an idea what I'm shooting for. Okay, well, that's interesting. You can always clean it up and start over.